All right, while I was down here playing around, I thought I would try something that I've been wanting to try for a while. This is a keyhole cutter, and basically what it allows you to do is go into the part, jog, you know, in your X or Y, and then reverse out, and it leaves a circular hole for a screw hole, and then leaves a minor diameter slot so that you could hang something on the wall on a screw head or something like that. So I very quickly edited just an NC file in Notepad to make the Z enter and then jog and then reverse out. And I'm going to give this a shot and see what it looks like. This is some 3/4 inch oak that I had. This was actually a sign that I had cut before. It had some tear out, or actually part of the letter broke off because of the dryness of the wood. So I'm just using it as a scrap piece, and we'll see what it does. So that did pretty good. I didn't have to change anything. You could hear the bit load up when it was down in the slot. And I'm thinking if I would have been using some air possibly blowing in, or at least getting some air blowing around the hole, it would have pulled out a lot of that sawdust. But it handled it. Didn't break. I wasn't expecting it to go flying. So that's basically it, if you can see that in the detail of the shot. So you can have a screw, you would have it upside down as it is right now on the part. So if this was a sign that was usable, or a placard or what have you, picture frame, then you could have a screw sticking out of the wall and the head would go in the big hole, and then it would slide over the shank of the screw and it would hold it onto the wall. You can actually buy metal inserts that allow you to do the same thing. But again, you have to pocket out the back of it, usually with a router bit or a chisel, to give a recess for that flat piece to be screwed into the back flush. And then you have to set it with two screws usually. So if you have the ability to do this, and you can do this with a plunge router. I don't have a plunge router. I just happen to have this guy. So I just always wanted to play with it. I'd had that bit for a while, never used it, so it turned out good. So now that I've got that tool path, the only thing I might would change, and I guess it depends on the species of wood, is that I may actually make it a little bit shallower. That flange is at least 1/8 of an inch. So anyway, but that's just, I'm just nitpicking. So anyway, thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe, and be sure to check out my website, neo7cnc.com, and there's always new things on there. So appreciate everybody's time, and we will talk to you soon.